Good morning, all of you. So today our topic is area of regular hexagon. Area of regular hexagon. You know very well, regular means all sides are equal. Hexa means six sided. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If all these sides are equal, and you just remember, this is, these are the longest diagonals, and all are equal in regular hexagon. Only these three are equal, and if they meet at O, and these points be some A, B, C, D, E, F, then what can you say? AB is equal to BC is equal to CD is equal to DE is equal to EF is equal to FA. And moreover, this AD is equal to BE is equal to CF. Moreover, this AD is equal to 2 times of AB, BC, whatever may be. That means here, one more thing you can say, AO is equal to OD. OC is equal to OF, OB is equal to OE. Here OE is the midpoint of these three sides. Okay, see what can you conclude here? So then OA is equal to OD is equal to AB means it is possible in regular hexagon. Okay, according to angles, you get all these are equal to 60 degrees. So it is an equilateral triangle. So here it is equilateral triangle means here how many possible equilateral triangles? 6 equilateral triangles are possible. And all these areas are equal. And the side length will be, you can consider for all of them is some AB. Let us take this is some A. Okay. So here you just remember the, these are the properties of regular hexagon. See. So what can you say? AB is equal to AD by 2. That means BE by 2 also, CF by 2 also we can write. Okay, see, you know the area of equilateral triangle. What is the equilateral triangle area? Root 3 by 4 into A square. Here A is side length. Okay, so now to find the area of regular hexagon is equal to, here how many equilateral triangles are there? 6 equilateral triangles having same area, 6 into, so each area is equal to root 3 by 4 into, side length is over here, you take AB or small a, I am taking along AB only, so this is AB whole square, other words, 6 into, if you want to use a diagonal, AD, so 6 into root 3 by 4 into, so how can you convert in terms of AB? AD is equal to AB by 2 whole square. That means, AB is equal to AD by 2 whole square. AB is equal to what? AD by 2 whole square. So, if you know, these are opposite points, that means end points we can say. Here AD are end points, BE are end points, CF are end points. If they given end points, that means diagonal end points. If they given side lengths, whose adjacent vertices means AB, side length. Okay. So based on this one, you take one example. If 2 comma 4, 6 comma 7, are ends of regular hexagon, then find area. Okay, so area is equal to, what is the formula? 6 into root 3 by 4 into, here they are given ends of a regular hexagon. Ends means you can take either A, D or B, E or C, F. So I am taking this is A, this is D. So what can I write? 6 into root 3 by 4 into AD by 2 whole square. So what is AD length? So 6 into root 3 by 4 into AD means root over 6 minus 2 whole square. Here I am finding AD root over 6 minus 2 whole square. 4 square, that is 16. Plus 7 minus 4 whole square, that is 3 square, 9. So root 25, that is equal to 5. So this is nothing but 5 square by 2 square. See, totally here 6 into root 3 into 25 by 4 into 4. So here 2 3 times going, here 2 times going. So 3 25 is a 75 root 3 by 2 4s are 8 square units. This is the answer for this question. So just remember the formula. Next one is collinear points. Okay, so 3 points A, B, C are said to be collinear. So this one is, we have already, we have in 10th class. Okay, if first one is slope of AB is equal to slope of BC or slope of CA, anyone you can use. In other words, we know if ABC are collinear means in previous videos we completed. So maybe if it is ABC, so AB plus BC is equal to CA, that is one way. So these are the different methods. Okay. So you know very well AB plus BC is equal to CA, like that. If you get the, then also you can say 3 points are collinear. So in other words, slope of AB is equal to slope of BC, or area of triangle ABC is equal to 0. So what is the slope of AB? How can you find out slopes? So you go for one more. That is, if A is equal to AX1, Y1, BX2, Y2, then slope of AB is equal to Y2 minus Y1, difference, by X2 minus X1. Or if you take minus common, what you have here? Minus of Y1 minus Y2. Here also minus common, minus of X1 minus X2. Minus minus get cancelled, Y1 minus Y2 by X1 minus X2. In two ways you can write. Okay, if you start from first point, so go for Y1 minus Y2 by X1 minus X2. If you go for, if you start from second point, Y2 minus Y1 by X2 minus X1. Okay, next one. First, suppose, if you want to find out the area of triangle formed by AX1, Y1, BX2, Y2, C, MX2 plus NX1 by M plus N, and my2 plus ny1 by m plus n. If the points are in this form, x1 y1, x2 y2, mx2 plus nx1 by m plus n, my2 plus ny1 by n plus n, or mx2 minus nx1 by m minus n, my2 minus ny1 by m minus n. That means, what can you conclude here? So, by very clearly, by observation, if you take a comma b here, c is here, it is m is to n. C divides AB in the ratio M is to N, then C becomes to this one only. So then what can you conclude here? C, A, C, B are collinear points. Then what is the area of this triangle? The area of the triangle formed by given 3 points is nothing but 0. Okay? In the same way, if first of all, the point A is A comma B plus C, B is B comma C plus A, C is C comma A plus B. Whenever the points are in this form, just it is in the cyclic order. So A, B, C, if you go for, first point is A comma B plus C, second point B comma C plus A, third point C comma A plus B, then this area becomes to 0. Why this becomes to 0 means, so go for slope of AB, slope of BC. slope of AB. What you get? Y2 minus Y1 by X2 minus Y, X1. C plus A minus of B plus C. Minus of B plus C means minus B minus C. So plus C minus C get cancelled. You have A minus B. Numerator is A minus B. Denominator B minus A. Okay. So B minus A means this is nothing but A minus B means you can add minus of B minus A. So after minus of B minus A, what you have? B minus A get cancelled. You have only minus 1. Next, slope of BC you take. What is that? BC means A plus B minus of C plus A. So minus C minus A. So A get cancelled. You have B minus C by C minus B. So here also, if you take minus common in numerator, minus of C minus B. C minus B cancel, we have minus 1. So here what can you say? Slopes are equal. Whenever slopes are equal, then area of triangle ABC is equal to 0. Very clear. Our slope of AB is equal to slope of BC, those are collinear points. The collinear points, you never form a triangle. So area is equal to 0. These are the based on collinear points. Next one is parallel triangle. See, you take any triangle ABC, take the feet of the altitudes. That means if it is perpendicular, meet at D. So this is the feet of the altitude from A. Next, if you go for from B, you take one more perpendicular, this is the feet of altitude from B. Similarly, this is the feet of altitude from C. If you join these three triangles, these three points, the new triangle formed by the feet of the altitudes of a triangle ABC is called parallel triangle. Okay? See, some applications you see from the parallel triangle. Once you observe very clearly, it is the right angle triangle. So it is 90 degrees means this is also 90 degrees. So I write clearly here. A, B, C. D, E, F. So it is perpendicular because feet of the altitude. For the parallel triangle I am saying. Okay. So then it is 90 degrees. So this triangle is a right angle triangle. Same. Here A, B, E is the right angle triangle. So this is 90 degrees and this is the angle A. So left over this is 90 minus A. Clear? Similarly, this is the right angle triangle and it is 90 degrees. So it is A. So obviously it will be 90 minus A. Okay? So take one example here, 90 minus A, 90 minus A. So I am drawing that one. This is A, B, C and this is D, E, F. See, once you observe carefully, this is 90 degrees. This is 90 degrees. It is 90 degrees. Again, I am drawing here. See, it is 90 means it is also 90. See here. It is a quadrilateral. Actually, these 3 meet at this point. Okay, this is the quadrilateral. Okay, four sided, so quadrilateral. So, and the opposite angle says, sum of opposite angles say 90 degrees. This is 90, this is 90. So, if in a quadrilateral, sum of opposite angles is equal to 180 degrees. So, remaining two, sum of remaining two angles also 180 degrees. So, if sum of opposite angles is 180 degrees, then that quadrilateral is called cyclic quadrilateral. That means those four vertices lies on the circuit. Okay, see here, whenever it is the circle, so observe here, this is the segment, okay, this is the segment, so this segment is nothing but, here this segment makes an angle, here something. And the same segment making an angle here, something. These two angles are equal. Okay. Angles subtended by the same angles are equal. You know, in 9th class circles, angles subtended by the same segments are equal. Okay. So, this is the segment. From this segment, this is the angle. From this segment, this is the angle. So, what is this angle here? 90 minus A you got here. 90 minus A. Same angle here, 90 minus A. This is the angle, this part. These two are equal. So, it will be 90 minus A. Similarly, if you take, this is the quadrilateral, same like, it is, actually the altitudes, these are the, meet at this point, this is point of congruence, that is called the orthocenter. Center. Okay? Anyhow, this is O you take. See, again here also, B, D, O, F also cyclic quadrilateral. So, what is the angle here? Same angle will be here. That is also 90 minus A. So, what can you say? This is the AD. AD is the altitude. Okay. Same AD is nothing but angular bisector at D. Is it clear? So, that means the altitudes of triangle ABC are nothing but angular bisectors of triangle DEF. So, just I have considered here at a D point. Similarly, we can prove at E and F also. At E, these two angles will be 90 minus B. At F, these two angles will be 90 minus C. So, this is 90 minus B. This is also 90 minus B. It is 90 minus C. So, this is also 90 minus C. Is it clear? So, here the orthocenter of triangle ABC is nothing but the point of concurrence of angular bisectors of triangle DEF. Angular bisectors means in center. The point of concurrence of angular bisectors is in center. So, what can you conclude here? Orthocenter of orthocenter generally is known with O of triangle ABC is equal to in center means I, of triangle DEF. Here triangle DEF is nothing but parallel triangle. And one more concept you just remember, very very important. Here we can draw a circumcircle of triangle ABC and we can draw a circumcircle of parallel triangle DEF. Okay, this is the circumcircle of triangle DEF. This is the circumcircle of triangle ABC. So, just you can understand, triangle ABC, circumcircle of triangle ABC, you take capital R. Circum, that means the circum radius of triangle DEF, you take R dash. Circum radius of triangle ABC, R, circum radius of triangle DEF, that is parallel triangle, is, let us denote with R dash. Then, just remember, this is very very important. Circum radius of triangle DEF, that is R dash, is equal to circum radius of triangle ABC by 2. That is nothing but R by 2. R to R dash is equal to R. This one also we can prove, but proof is not important. You just remember. Next concept, in general, you know, excenters and in center. Once you revise that concept, this is triangle ABC and this is in center. In center means the point of concurrence of angle bisectors, internal angle bisectors. And excenters, this is I1, I2, I3 you take. In general, I1, I2, I3, if you join, it is this line segment obviously passing through vertices. Okay, this is the triangle I1, I2, I3. This is in center. You just remember actually how the excenters I1, I2, I3 form. That is nothing but this I1 formed by external angular bisectors of B, C and internal angular bisector of A. So this is nothing but external angular bisector from B. So these two angles are equal. Yes, just to understand. And internal angular bisector. Okay, so this I formed by internal angular bisector of B. That means these two angles are equal. Okay, now what can you conclude here? This one and this one are angular bisectors at B. See here, angular bisectors at B means, just remember, this is also 9th or 10th class concept. If it is the intersecting, two lines intersecting at point, some A you take, or B, whatever B. So this is the one of the angular bisector and this is another angular bisector. So at two intersecting lines, the angular bisectors of two intersecting lines are perpendicular to each other. That means these two are perpendicular to each other. This is very, very important concept. Why? Because let us take this angular bisector. This angle is some A by 2 because it is the vertex A, you understand? Or some, you take some X. This is also X. It is nothing but this is a straight angle up to here. So it is 2x means it will be 180 minus 2x. 180 minus 2x means this will be 90 minus x. This will be 90 minus x. So this is vertical opposite angle x. This is vertical opposite angle x. For this vertical opposite angle 90 minus x. For this vertical opposite angles 90 minus x. Okay. This is angle bisectors. Okay. Now we have to prove angle between these two. This 90 minus x and x, 90 minus x plus x, that is nothing but 90. So these two will be, angle between these two will be, angle bisectors will be 90 degrees. Okay. So this is one of the way to prove angle between angular bisectors is 90 degrees. In other words, one more way you can prove, these two are the two intersecting lines. This is one of the angular bisector, this is another angular bisector. So we have to find out angle between these two is 90 degrees. See, let us take here, this angle will be some x you take, this is some y you take. So it is x means this is also x. It is y means this is also y. So it will be y, it will be y. Okay. It will be x, it will be also x. So sum of all angles is equal to 360 degrees. So 4y's are there, 4x are there. 4x plus 4y is equal to 360 degrees. 4 common, x plus y is equal to 360. So x plus y is equal to 360 by 4, that is 90. So angle between these two lines is nothing but, that is x plus y is nothing but 90 degrees. So here also This is internal angular bisector, this is external angular bisector. So these two are perpendicular to each other. Whenever these two are perpendicular to each other means, so where it is 90 degrees, once you observe. See the angle between these two. Now tell me. So angle between these two is 90. This is also 90. Okay, clear? And one more thing, you remember. See, now then it will, B is the foot of the perpendicular. B is the foot of the perpendicular. Actually, if you expand this one, you get one of the foot of the perpendicular. Here, C is also one of the foot of the perpendicular. Here, A also one of the foot of the perpendicular. So, these are nothing but, then you can say triangle ABC is nothing but a pedal triangle. Okay, you leave it that one. After that, we will discuss about our pedal triangle. Now, what we are going to discussing, see here, this is 90 degrees, this is 90 degrees. Similarly, at C also, if you join this one, okay, this is external angular bisector, this is internal angular bisector. So, it is 90 and this will be also 90. Similarly, if you join these two, you may get like that only. So, 90, because it is in internal angular bisector, this is external angular bisector. Okay, so now what I am going to prove is, here I is, are the center of I1, I2, I3 or not? Once you check it out. I is ortho center of I1, I2, I3. What is ortho center? The point of concurrence of altitudes. See here, is it altitude or not? For this side I1, I3, this is altitude or not? Yes or no? From I1, I2, I3, if you join this one, what you have, it is a straight line. Because this is an internal angular bisector. From B, you are taking internal angular bisector. Okay, so it is, these B, I, I2 are collinear points. Remember, see here, once you observe, so from I2, it is one of the altitude. I2B is one of the altitude. Similarly, I1A is one of the altitude. Similarly, I3C is one of the altitude. The point of concurrence of these three altitudes is nothing but in center, I. So, then what can you conclude here? The in center, that means, the ortho center of I1, I2, I3 is nothing but in center of triangle ABC. See here, I am giving conclusion. So, ortho center of triangle I1, I2, I3 is I. So, in previous video, I gave one conclusion. If ortho center of triangle ABC is O, then ortho center of triangle OAB is C. Okay, like that. So you can write here ortho center of triangle I2, I3 is I1. The ortho center of triangle I2, I1 is I3. Or here you write I1, I3, that is I2. And ortho center of triangle I1, I2 is I3. Okay, I gave the this concept in previous video. So you just remember, this is very very important concept. The ortho center of I1, I2, I3 is I. Similarly, I1, I2, I is I3. I1, I3 is I2. And I3, I2 is I1. Okay. So, next concept. So, already I gave you one concept, that is in previous concept. What is that? In triangle ABC, ortho center you take, foot of the altitudes, okay, D, E, F, these are the altitudes. So this is ortho center. If you join these two, This is the trapezoidal triangle. So are those center of triangle ABC is nothing but in center of triangle DF. Yes. See here also, here I is nothing but are those center of I1, I2, I3. And the same I is nothing but in center of triangle ABC. Here ABC act as I1, I2, I3 and DEF act as ABC. So what can you conclude here? Triangle ABC is pedal triangle of I1, I2, I3. Okay? Triangle ABC is pedal triangle of I1, I2, I3. That means here ABC are nothing but feet of the perpendiculars. Feet of the perpendiculars from I1, I2, I3. If you join this one, this is nothing but feet of the perpendicular. This is foot only. Perpendicular only here. If you join this one, this is perpendicular. If you join this one, this is perpendicular. So very clearly, triangle ABC is pedal triangle of I1, I2, I3. Here, I is nothing but in center of triangle ABC and I is nothing but ortho center of I1, I2, I3. Next concept, 9-point circle. See, let us take this is the triangle ABC. Okay, ABC. Here D E F are midpoints. Okay, D E F are midpoints and P Q R. P Q R PQR are feet of altitudes. Okay, and some L M N. That means if you join this one, you can understand easily. If you join feet of altitudes, what you have? Let us take P is here, Q is here, R is here. Okay, PQR are the feet of the altitude. Then it will becomes to ortho center of triangle ABC. That means altitudes, point of congruence of altitudes. Okay, so let us take some L here, M here, N. Sorry, here L, here M, here N. That means L, M, N are midpoints of OA, OB, OC. Here OA is nothing but ortho center. L, M, N are midpoints of OA, OB, OC respectively. Here OA is ortho center. So how many total points here? Once you check it out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Through these 9 points, we can draw a circle. That circle is called 9-point circle. See, that circle may be like this. So, not exactly. So, if you construct with the measurements, you will get the exact circle. So we'll just take this is D point. So this circle is called the 9-point circle. So that circle is passing through midpoints of the sides of triangle ABC and the feet of the perpendiculars or feet of the altitudes of triangle ABC and the midpoints of the OA, OB, OC, where O is orthocenter. That circle is called the 9-point circle. Very, very important. So based on this 9-point circle, so the center of this 9-point circle, not orthocenter, that may be some N. The center of the 9-point circle is denoted by N. Center of 9-point circle is capital N. Okay. So that is also inside of the triangle only. Just remember. For triangle ABC, we have more centers. What are them? Centroid we have, circumcenter we have, orthocenter you have, and this 9-point center also. These 4 points are collinear points. Okay, Euler proved that one also. Okay, so that is also in the form of, for suppose this is the triangle ABC. So it is, if you take O, N, G, S. So, orthocenter, 9-point circle, center, and the centroid, circumcenter. Okay? See, these 4 points are collinear points. Same we know, centroid divides OS in the ratio 2:1. Okay? In the same manner, here, 9-point circle divides OS in the ratio 1:1. That is, 9-point circle is midpoint of OS. See here, so this is O, N, G, S if you take, N is the midpoint of OS and G is the, G divides OS in the ratio 2:1. So, by balancing these two concepts, what are the ratios of ON:NG:GS? That means here you write, what is that? That is, N is midpoint of OS. First point, N is midpoint of OS. That means orthocenter, circumcenter. And G divides OS in, that means in the ratio 2:1. That means N divides OS in the ratio 1:1. Okay. So, after balancing these two, so how it will be the parts of ON, NG, GS. If you go for this is 3 parts, just estimate it. If you go for this is 1 part, this is 2 parts, how it will be? N divides OS in the ratio 1:1. So 3:1 + 2, that is 3:3, that is 1:1 only. So it was satisfied. Next, what is our next concept? G divides OS in the ratio 2:1. So 3 + 1 = 4, 4:2. 4:2 means 2:1 only. So it is satisfied. So ON:2. So what can I write? ON:2, NG:2, GS=3:1:2. So here you can write one more, right? ON:2, NG=3:1. Okay, next ON:2, NS, that is 1:1, already we have written. Next, ON:2, NS, already 1:1. Next, OG:2, GS, that is also completed. So, enough. ON:2, NG=3:1, ON:2, NS=1:1, and one more thing, ON:2, NG=GS=3:1:2. So this is very, very important concept. Just remember. So based on this one, I give some notes for you. You just copy it and you can understand the problems. If you didn't understand, tomorrow we have Zoom class. Okay? In that class, you can ask me.